Okay, here we go. I was not expecting to do this testimony today, but here I am, and I was inspired by a troll of all people, because they were just putting really hateful comments on all my photos or all my videos, and the one really made me laugh because it just had to do with something about how I was wearing a ton of makeup, and that's because I was insecure and no one loved me or something like that. And I was like, sir, I covered up this spot here, but like, sir, I have no makeup. So thank you. Thank you. Yeah, I covered up this spot too. Anyways, at the time, I was wearing nothing. And I mean, outside of these two spots, besides the point, I felt really good. I was like, thank you. Thank you for noticing the fact that I apparently look like I have makeup on even when I feel like a pile of poo. So I appreciate that. Anyways, then I looked up the fact, did you know that there's paid trolls? And then that got me thinking. I was like, well, I must be going along the right path and doing a lot lately for the enemy to be so adherent. Because I know the enemy's been tempting me lately in different ways, and I've been really called lately in my prayer time with God to just step back and not let the temptation of emotionally elicited temptations get to me. So things that essentially elicit an emotional reaction or an emotional response, and that one's been a huge one that God's been helping me heal through because I used to be addicted to my emotions. And from time to time, I mean, we're human, we're always flawed, we're always going to be to have a sinful nature at heart. And so this is something that he's working through with me, which I am so blessed over. And that got me thinking, well, you know what? If the enemy is attacking me on YouTube of all places, then let's just keep this ball rolling. So I have been saved. Honestly, I would say I've been a, like, hands down officially saved January 2021. I thought I was saved January 2020 because I declared my life to Jesus, but it's hard to explain for someone who isn't saved, but I still didn't want to read the Bible. I was putting God in this little box. I was still falling victim to sin a lot. And then I had realized that, and some amazing person got on a phone call with me, and we went through the Ten Commandments. And then that night, anyways, I'll get to that later. But anyways, the January 2021, so 10 months ago, that's when I really gave my heart to Jesus, and I'll explain sort of what went down. So, a background of me, I have been a personal trainer for the past 7 years and health and lifestyle and fitness coach. And the first few years of that, I definitely taught a lot of new age practices, even to my lack of knowledge or lack of awareness. I was into crystals. And I got really into new age stuff once my last bodybuilding competition, I allowed myself to succumb to eating disorders. And then after the eating disorders, I got depressed and, well, just throughout it, I suppose. Man, I'm just realizing as I'm talking, I haven't even really shared this with anyone. So, I don't know. I hope this can resonate with someone. I know some people who have subscribed to this channel, even though there's next to no one, will know sort of part of my story. And so some of this information will be new behind the scenes information that I haven't disclosed to the public, and only, you know, a handful of people know of my full story. So back in 2017, I finished my second bodybuilding competition. I was already in a really bad mindset. I was focusing on manifestation and positivity, and I wasn't aware fully of the psychological side of bodybuilding and the importance of reverse dieting. So I allowed myself to develop an eating disorder because my leptin and ghrelin levels and everything were so off being that level of lean. And I was not well educated enough at the time, and I didn't have that proper education or guidance or support to help prevent that. So hand in hand with that led to me gaining a lot of weight really quickly. I shattered my metabolism for years, and when I became depressed and full went binge eating and then a little bit of bulimia, I really then started into crystals and more power of positivity, law of attraction stuff. And then just my friend group shifted to partiers. So I ended up doing a lot of rave drugs, and the following year of 2018, I got really into the party scene. I guess, I mean, like, I did cocaine, I did Molly, and drank a lot. And on top of that, I was just dieting and I was doing a lot of other bad things. Just, I guess, excessively working out and also getting my validation from men. And I was a really broken human being. And after, and I actually stopped, I had to stop coaching because obviously with that lifestyle of partying and drugs and everything else, I was not living the lifestyle that I was trying to coach, and it was horrible for me because I wanted that life so badly, and I truly believed in all of the health and wellness things that I was teaching. So, but I couldn't do it because I was just I wasn't I was I felt like a fraud. So I had a random trip to Australia, and essentially February 2017, I just had to I was hating my life. I was starting to prep for my third bodybuilding competition, and I would binge the night before, and then I would wake up with this earth-shattering just anxiety. Like I feel my heart beating faster just even thinking about it, and like I would just wake up with the biggest panic attack. And I remember waking up the one morning and I was like, it can't be like this. Like maybe I can push myself through this and get to nationals, but what's on the other side of that? How much more am I going to destroy myself? And so I quit, and I still ended up destroying myself. I went from hyper restriction bodybuilding lifestyle into the other side, which was the partying and the drug scene and all of that. And so, was it healthier? I don't know. It was that whole, I need a release, I need a break. And in my mind, I justified it in that way. And in February, just before the party scene, I had made this decision to, okay, well, I'm single, I don't have any attachments, why don't I just go to Australia? So I ended up applying for a working holiday, and then I committed to leaving December 1st. So between the application and leaving was the whole summer of partying and raving. And I think if I hadn't left, I don't even want to know where I would be today. I would probably be in a very, very bad spot and not the person that I am today. Praise Jesus. And I know the Holy Spirit was working because if he hadn't taken me out of that, then I would have just been, I don't know. I don't know where I could have been, but so I went to Australia. And my mind, I had this picture of waitressing on a beach for a year and traveling and doing all these fun things. And I don't know how it happened. Holy Spirit was trying to push me in certain ways, but I last minute decided it the job wasn't gonna pay enough, so I applied for a farm position at a horse farm, a stud farm, and that was the most incredible labor-driven, horrible but eye-opening experience in itself. We have it good over here in Canada, and I was treated like an immigrant worker, and I was kicked off the property because I was trying to give notice. And then shortly after that, I broke my foot while hiding out at the handyman's farm, trying to find where to go next. It was awful. I didn't want to, anyways. So, and amidst all of that, I met this girl, and we became good friends, and she had a really special gift. And I'm not gonna go too much into her story. I think that's something that she needs to share on her own time if she's ever going to share that. But this girl had, due to her circumstances, and God had given her some special gifts to be able to see things like auras and dead people slash demons. I mean, obviously, like, we didn't refer to them as that, but in hindsight, I mean, most things are demonic entities and not good things. So that was a huge, in the middle of me not knowing at all what I was doing in my life, at the bottom of the barrel, I found a friend who was super interesting, and she said I had a pure aura about her, so I was curious and I trusted her, and for that time, like, my whole life was her life, and God helped show me so many things through our time together, and that's why I am where I am now. Because of this special paranormal experience, which at the time I thought was great, I got even more into the crystals, I got into the saging, I got into the tarot cards, I got into so much. And at one and essentially what happened through my time there was I experienced a lot of paranormal things. The house that we were in had ghosts and stuff, and so they would bang cupboards, and I still today it's just a habit, but I started sleeping with a pillow over my head out of fear because I could feel things watching me. And at one point, I remember I was at one point I moved and was in this other city and had a little apartment room while I was working at a restaurant. I think this is a couple months after my foot had healed. And I remember in the middle of the night waking up because this man's voice was just like, "Hey!" And it was just above my head, and I thought I was dreaming, but then after that, like, my friend, she was like, "I don't get good vibes in this room." So, of course, I kept saging, I kept doing the tarot cards, I kept doing the manifesting. We had a moment where I left the phone to go to the bathroom, but she was still on there, and I came back and the phone was off, and I was like, "Hey, did you hang up?" And she's like, "No, you hung up on me. I heard breathing and then the phone hung up." And so I kept obviously getting more like clearing crystals, and it kept getting worse and getting worse. A few days later, it pushed me down some stairs, and then that night, I just had this feeling, since it was getting violent, that I was in really, like, I've never been more scared in my entire life. And I remember that night waking up, and the thing, like, whatever it was pushing me in my bed. I remember that night too. I was like, I had all my tarot cards out, I had all my protection stuff, right? This thing is probably laughing at me. And I was being pushed in my sleep. I could feel myself moving in the bed. And when that happened, I don't know what came over me, but I just started saying the Lord's Prayer. And I said it over and over and over again. And it left. And was the scariest night of my life. But God used that to make me realize that if that side is real, then the good has to be real. And I had a few more months. I mean, there was things that she saw that were pretty scary, and she helped protect me in her capacity. But as we know, only Jesus can protect us, so it really was, there wasn't anything that I wasn't protected or we weren't protected at all. So I had a few more months over there, and then thank the Lord, my farm hours were short, so I couldn't apply for my second visa, and then I had to go home. And when I came home, I mean, I was still into the crystals and the tarot at that time, but praise the Lord of all people. So I came back and I wasn't anywhere close to the city that I used to live. I didn't want to be a part of that. I didn't want to go back to those friends just because the environment it was too tempting for me. And so I ended up, staying with my family for a bit. This is now end of 2019, so this is November 2019. And anyway, so the people that, sorry, I'm getting, there's so many other things, I'm trying to keep this condensed. So the next thing was who I was connected with afterwards. And of all people, it were the two friends that I had, which I maybe saw once a year, the outskirt friends, but they were the only Christian friends that I had. And praise the Lord, somehow it was those two ladies that I reconnected with, and I went to church with them and just sort of did the part. I was still into the tarot, still into the crystals, but I knew God was real at that point. And then God blessed me with this new friend's story and her incredible experiences of the Holy Spirit fixing her rib cage and some awesome other things. And because I'd already experienced all that crazy stuff in Australia, I was like, I know, like I believe, I full-heartedly, and I saw her rib cage change. Like she used to, it was totally different. She used to have this caved-in chest, and it was, I don't know, it was awesome. And so, yeah, 2020 was God trying to slowly get my grip off of all of my old crutches, all my old crutches, like the crystals and the tarot and all of that. And that was a full year of just slowly shifting to understanding who Jesus was, who the Holy Spirit was. And I kind of had God in the box, sort of like, just church on Sunday sort of thing, maybe just do it online kind of thing. And then January 2021, I got on the phone with an amazing guy, and he went through the Ten Commandments with me again, and he was very evangelical, and I'm so blessed for his guidance. And he's like, you gotta repent and proclaim Jesus Christ, Lord and Savior. In my mind, I was like, I did that last year at my friend's church, but I was like, no, I've still been sinning. I still haven't dedicated my heart. And through reading the Bible this year, I'm so close. I think I'm less than 100 days left of reading. I'm so excited. But so I was like, you know what? I have to do this for real this time. So I put on Christian worship music and I just sat there and I apologized and I repented and I proclaimed him Lord and Savior, and I repented and I proclaimed him Lord and Savior. And I remember just being so scared. And I would say that out loud, and I was so scared. And I kept repeating it, and I kept saying it, and I kept saying it. I was so scared. And then all of a sudden, this just feeling of
scared anymore. And I was laughing. And I was laughing, and I felt so much love. And I knew at that moment, Jesus had me. And it was the wildest thing after that. All of a sudden, I knew the Holy Spirit was in me because all of a sudden I was like so intensely like excited about reading the Bible, and just I wanted more, and I wanted more of Jesus, and I wanted more of God, and I couldn't understand. It was like the coolest mystery novel that was truth right in front of me, and I was all of a sudden after that night, it was just I wanted more of him, and I wanted to know him, and I wanted to follow in his path. And it's been 10 months of getting to know Jesus, getting to know his character, and getting to know the character of God. And I got a biblical counselor for a while, so I could just, it wasn't enough. Like, I was doing online sermons and reading, and it wasn't enough. And so I just was like sinking my teeth into just knowing the word and knowing God. And I am still far from perfect, and we know that the only good thing in ourselves is Jesus, because we have a sinful nature at heart, but the greatest thing is that once you're saved, you have choice not to sin, knowing that Jesus died on the cross for our sins. He paid our sins. And it breaks my heart knowing that there's people I love that, like, I just want eternal life and eternal joy. Joy through living for God's purpose and living as a child of God. I just want that for everyone. And it just so became so clear about the idolization and the worshiping and the worshiping other things that weren't God, and nothing compares to the power of Jesus Christ. Nothing. Nothing. And I prayed so hard over this next bodybuilding, this next prep journey of mine. And so far, God has made it fruitful. God has made it fruitful, and it hasn't even, we haven't even ramped up yet. And God has made it so fruitful. So thankful and so blessed. And I know that I'm on the right track when I feel more temptation to sin in life, and people are shutting me down, because I know that I'm on the right track. I know I'm on God's path and God's purpose for me. And I just want that for everyone. I want them not to be dead in their sins. I want them to be spiritually alive. And so, yeah, this whole YouTube thing has been just to share my journey, I guess, and just be real. So, yeah, that's my testimony. And I haven't told it to a lot of people, just a couple. My pastor and two of the closest people I know. So, yeah, that's that. I hope this touches someone, or like, I just hope someone, like, my testimony can just be fruitful for someone else. Like, they can watch this, and I don't know, maybe one part of my journey can just really, really resonate with them and really speak to them.